Hello friends, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Ramasre Prasad from Department of Geography, Bhim Rao Ambedkar College, University of Delhi, Delhi. Today I am going to deliberate upon global temperature distribution, horizontal and vertical, which comes under the paper climatology. First of all, let us discuss what could be the learning outcome of this module. While going through this module, you will be able to define and distinguish between heat and temperature, explain different controlling factors of temperature, describe the temperature conditions during summer and winter, illustrate the annual mean temperature distribution over the globe, explain the average annual temperature range over the globe, explain the vertical temperature distribution and its inversion, and describe different types of temperature inversions. Coming to the introduction, during peak summer days, you must have heard people saying that it is too hot, or during peak winter, you might agree that people say it is too cold. Too hot or too cold is referred to heat, while people mean it temperature. The quality of hotness or coldness refers to the state of their air, which we call heat. Heat is basically the transfer of thermal energy from one substance to another. This transfer happens due to difference in hotness or coldness. Temperature is different from heat. Sometimes we use heat and temperature as synonyms, which is not fair. Temperature of any substance is the degree of intensity of heat available in that body. In fact, temperature is a measure of average heat of thermal energy of the particles in a substance. Its most popular measure is in either degree Celsius or Fahrenheit. You have already studied about the heating and cooling of atmosphere and distribution of insulation over the globe in module 4 and 5. You must be well aware that the temperature varies substantially. The global distribution of temperature is directly and very closely associated with the distribution of insulation. There are several factors affecting them. The main concern of this module is to study the factors controlling the temperature and its global distribution in both horizontal and vertical perspectives. Now, coming to the source of energy on the Earth. The prime source of energy for the Earth's surface is the Sun. It comes in the form of electromagnetic radiation in different wavelengths or bands, or electromagnetic spectrum. Some of these bands, thermal and visible, are heating the Earth's surface as well as its atmosphere. Another source of energy is geothermal energy from Earth's interior also reaches the surface, but its role in temperature distribution is negligible. Therefore, we will discuss about the distribution of temperature received only from the Sun. Let us discuss about the heat and temperature. Heat is a form of energy. It measures the total energy in a volume of substance retained by all the molecules, which we call total kinetic energy. Its measuring unit are joule or calorie. The standard unit of the rate of heat transferred is what? Generally defined as 1 joule per second. Temperature is a measure of degree of hotness or coldness of this substance. In other words, heat represents the molecular movement of particles of a substance, while the temperature is the measurement of degree of hotness of the substance. It is the measure of average kinetic energy of the molecules of the substance we are referring to. The water in two containers, a bucket and a cup, has same temperature at 25 degrees Celsius. The same amount, that is total energy of heat, 50,000 joule, is provided to both the containers. The water in the cup gets heated more in comparison to the bucket, though the energy given was same. Remember, the definition given above, heat is total energy retained by all the molecules of the substance, that is water, while the temperature is the average kinetic energy of the substance. The movement of heat depends on the temperature difference between the two bodies. Heat always moves from a body of higher temperature to that of lower temperature. Primarily, it is measured in Kelvin unit in the study of physical sciences, but most commonly measured in Celsius or Fahrenheit in day-to-day usage. They are denoted as 0 degree Kelvin, 0 degree centigrade, and 0 degree Fahrenheit. Temperature in 0 degree Celsius or 0 degree Fahrenheit would be taken into account while describing its distribution and not the Kelvin scale of measurement. Now, coming to the global temperature distribution, the global temperature distribution is explained in two ways, horizontal and vertical. But before coming to the direct distribution of temperature over the globe, in these two perspectives, it is important to study the factors which control the temperature. Now, coming to the principal controllers of temperature, the temperature on the Earth's surface and its atmosphere is not alike, but it varies significantly. The variation is controlled by various factors. Important among them are latitude, altitude, length of the day, continentality, wind and ocean currents, aspect, topography, and vegetation. Now, coming to the latitude. Latitude is one of the most important and primary factor affecting the unequal distribution of temperature over the globe. The intensity of heating determines the degree of temperature on the Earth, and so is its distribution. Overall, an annual maximum energy is received on or near the equator. Away from the equator towards pole, the received energy from the sun decreases, and hence the temperature also keeps on declining. The low latitudes area receive more solar radiation due to two reasons. Effects of atmosphere. In low latitude, particularly near equator, the solar beam of the light travels for lesser distances in the atmosphere, hence less reflection, less obstruction, and less absorption is observed in the atmosphere. This results in greater amount of solar energy receiving on the Earth, and records higher temperature. On the other hand, in the higher latitude, particularly in the polar region, the reverse conditions prevail and hence less temperature is recorded. Angle of incidence. In the low latitude areas, the incident of sun rays is vertical or near to vertical, and hence the beam of rays, that is energy coming from the sun, is concentrated to a smaller areas. Therefore, the heat received per unit area is higher and thus more temperature is recorded. But in the higher latitude areas, the incidence of sun rays is oblique and hence beams of rays spread over larger areas. This leads to less energy received per unit of area, leading to less temperature in the higher latitudes or polar areas. Now let us see about the altitude. Temperature is inversely correlated with altitude. Increase in altitude shows decrease in temperature. You might be remembering that sun energy hits the Earth's surface first. The air at its contact is heated and finally the atmosphere gets the heat by different methods. Another reason for more temperature in the lower atmosphere is the presence of more dust particles, water vapor, aerosols, and other solid minute substances in the lower level of the atmosphere. They are also absorbing the incoming solar radiation as well as the terrestrial long wave radiation. In this process, lower atmosphere is relatively warmer in comparison to upper atmosphere, which is clean and free from minute solid substances. Now let us discuss about the length of the day. With change in season, length of the day changes, and it is due to this the apparent departure of the incident of sun rays. In general, more duration of sunlight results into greater amount of energy received. When it is summer time in northern hemisphere, it is winter time for southern hemisphere. During June, places in the northern hemisphere have greater duration of day hours. The sun is vertical on and near to Tropic of Cancer. Therefore, higher temperature are recorded around the Tropic of Cancer in June than at the equator. The duration of day at 30 degree north latitude is about 14 hours, while at 50 degree north it is more than 16 hours. It is also worth mentioning that greater acute angle of sun rays is in polar areas does not increase temperature effectively, even though the duration of day are more than 24 hours. When it is summer time for southern hemisphere, it is winter for the northern hemisphere. During January, it is the reverse case of what it is happening during June. Continentality. Continentality refers to the control of land mass on temperature and its range, and it depends on distance from sea. As the distance from sea or water bodies increases, continentality increases. It means range of temperature increases in coastal areas due to marine influence. Range of temperature is low. These variations are related to nature of surface or to differential rates of heating and cooling of the land and water. two stations, Dolaz, which is situated at 32 degrees 51 minutes north latitude, and Santiago, 32 degrees 44 minutes north of United States of America, which are situated on the same latitude. San Diego, near the sea coast, has moderate temperature, that is, not very high and not very low, while Dolaz, situated in the interior part of the country, has extremes of temperature, that is, very high temperature in summer and very low in winter. Therefore, the annual range of temperature at San Diego is only 9 degrees Celsius, while it is 24 degrees Celsius as Dolaz. The region is condition of continentality. Now, talking about winds and ocean currents. Winds and ocean currents affect the temperature of any region. Winds are the horizontal movement of air from high air pressure region to low pressure. Ocean currents also transport the heat energy from one region to another. The prevailing winds blowing towards land from the ocean modify the temperature. For example, winds blowing from the warmer ocean, that is tropical region, keep the coast warm, while winds blowing from the cold, that is polar region, surface makes the coastal area cold. The same thing happens with the ocean currents as well, because they also affect as per their characteristics. Now, talking about the aspect, the temperature at local or regional level is affected by the aspect of the area. Aspect refers to the direction of the place or area, especially to the angle of the sun rays it faces. Due to inclined axis of the earth and its rotation, the sway of the sun is apparently seen between the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. Beyond these limits, east-west lying mountains, northern slope in the northern hemisphere and southern slope in the southern hemisphere do not get direct sunlight. They have shadows of the mountain, while the southern facing slope in the north, northern hemisphere, gets direct and most vertical sun rays. In southern hemisphere, northern facing slopes gets brighter and effective sun energy, and the temperature is high on the sun facing slopes. The slope away from the sun faces chilled condition during winter, as winds coming from poles are also cold. Sun facing slope is protected from cold winds. Sun facing slopes have very good condition for photosynthesis and have very dense vegetation, while on the surface away from the sun, the ideal condition for photosynthesis lacks, and so does the vegetation. Now, let us talk about the topography and vegetation. The term topography refers to the appearance of the surface of any particular area in terms of differences in height, like nature created mountain hills, plains, plateau, or human created different cultural features. Therefore, various features found on the earth's surface also affect the temperature as per interactions within the incoming solar radiation. The differences in temperature is amplified by topography. If you compare hot desert with that of vegetative area or rainforest area of grassland. In the same way, types of soil or vegetation affects the temperature a lot. the alteration of the land cover also alters heating and cooling process in a changed situation. Hence, clearance in the soil and vegetation are affected on the distribution of temperature. Now, let us discuss about the horizontal temperature distribution. The energy coming from the sun is not uniform all through the globe, which we have already pointed out in discussion about factors affecting temperature. Due to the effect of several factors, incoming energy and temperature are widely varying over the surface of the earth. In general, equatorial region is hot and its temperature is high throughout the year. Generally, from equator to polewards, temperature keeps on declining. The lowest temperature is at and near the pole. In other words, the average annual temperature has a gradual decrease towards pole in the beginning from the equator, but after tropical zone, the decline is accelerated. After the temperature zone, the declining trend is in temperature is drastically enhanced. It is also due to locational disadvantages of the pole, far away from the sunlight, associated with other factors as explained a little while ago. Since the sun is almost vertical in the tropical zone, the annual average temperature varies between 22 degrees Celsius to 26 degrees Celsius. The 22 degree is at Tropic of Capricorn, lying in the southern hemisphere, along tropics in the Cancer, along tropics of Cancer, the annual average temperature is 24 degrees Celsius. The reason behind the difference is that southern hemisphere has more water bodies, while northern hemisphere has relatively more continental areas. As explained before, land areas record higher temperature than water bodies. It is due to this reason the temperature difference is absorbed. To represent distribution of temperature, isotherms are used. Isotherm is an imaginary line joining the places with same temperature. If we draw the isotherm of certain time over the world map, we would be in a position to have a spatial pattern of the distribution of temperature. Let us study them with respect to two positions, that one, when the sun is overhead at the Tropic of Cancer, and the second situation when the sun is overhead at Tropic of Capricorn. Now, coming to the sun overhead on the Tropic of Cancer in July. The sun is overhead at the Tropic of Cancer by the end of the third week of June, that is June 21st, at 23.5 degree north latitude. Entire northern hemisphere witness bright sun, greater insolation leading to high temperature throughout. But the maximum average temperature is not recorded in June, but it is in July. Therefore, the case of July is taken to study ideal summer month for northern hemisphere. The highest temperature is recorded over large chunk of area comprising Sahara Desert of northern Africa and desertic part of West Central Asia. This belt runs from Sahara Desert via Arabia to Thar. The high temperature zone is extended to the Indo-Gangetic Plain as well as Tibetan Plateau. This zone attracts the monsoon winds as it has intense low pressure due to high temperature. This low pressure zone is characterized by intertropical convergence zone, that is ITCZ. From this belt, the temperature is declining northward as well as southward. By the northern end of the Asiatic landmass, the average recorded air temperature is around 40 degrees Celsius. During northern hemisphere summer days, the isotherm turns towards northward over the land as it is hotter than the water. The condition is reversed on the ocean as the water bodies are not that hot as the land. Hence, the isotherm turns southward on the ocean of the northern hemisphere. Another low pressure system is developed over the northwestern Mexico and southwestern USA due to more intense record of temperature. The same pattern of isotherms are seen on northern American landmass. Overall, pattern of isotherm is reversed in southern hemisphere, particularly with the reference to the direction of bending isotherms on land and water. One very remarkable observation is seen on the isotherm map of July in southern hemisphere. During this period, incidence of sun rays is acute and hence insolation is less. It is the winter season for southern hemisphere. Isotherms are always parallel to each other with very narrow spacing. The isotherm's gradient is very steep. It is more so over the Atlantic landmass where the temperature is very low. Coming to the sun overhead on the Tropic of Capricorn, that is the month of January. The sun is overhead at the Tropic of Capricorn by the end of third week of December, that is by 21st December at 23.5 degrees south latitude. Entire southern hemisphere witnesses bright sun, greater insolation leading to high temperature throughout. But maximum average monthly temperature is not recorded in December, but it is in January. Therefore, case of January is taken to study ideal summer month for southern hemisphere. Both major continents, South America and Africa, are tapered towards south. There is no wide and large landmass in southern hemisphere as compared to the northern. The effects of ocean can be seen very clearly. Relatively, the temperature is recorded less. The maximum mean temperature of January is about 32 degrees Celsius over a small area of Western Australian desert. Over South America and Africa is around 27 degrees Celsius. The area bounded by 27 degrees Celsius isotherm wide over continents as well as on the Indian Ocean. The same is narrow over Western Pacific. Eastern Pacific is cool due to the cold ocean currents. Over the Atlantic Ocean, warm area is confined to a small and narrow belt enclosed by 27 degrees Celsius isotherm. Both Pacific and Atlantic are open oceans in comparison to the Indian Ocean. Hence, wider warm belt is seen on the map. From this zone, there is declining trend of temperature in both the directions, north and south. The isotherm of 21 degrees Celsius covers a large part of the globe. Beyond this isotherm, in both hemispheres, isotherms are coming closer and keep on declining towards both poles. The temperature gradient is increasing. It is greater in the northern hemisphere, particularly over the large land mass of Asia and North America. The lowest temperature around minus 40 degrees Celsius is recorded on the polar region of Canada, Iceland and Asian Siberia. Over the northern oceans, isotherms are turned towards pole, whereas on land mass their bend are towards south. It is because of the transport of heat from equatorial region to poleward through prevailing winds and ocean currents. Now coming to the annual mean temperature over the globe. We have already discussed about the distribution of temperature for summer and winter season, represented by 2 months, July and January. Since sun is always apparently on the move due to rotation of the earth on the inclined axis, there is continuously change in the distribution of temperature on the globe. Now let us talk about average annual temperature range. Average annual range of temperature is the difference between mean monthly temperature of the hottest and the coldest months. We have already discussed about distribution of temperature of two seasons, summer and winter. If the difference is computed between these months, that would give you the difference. The values shown with the isotherm are written in degrees Celsius. It is evident that annual range of temperature is very low in low latitude areas. It is less than 3 degrees Celsius or less. This is a narrow belt across Africa and South America in the equatorial region. This belt is much wider on the ocean surfaces. As long as we keep on marching towards poles, the annual range of temperature is increasing very sharply. This trend is very drastic in the northern hemisphere. This is due to presence of large land masses and associated high thermal ranges. Over the largest land mass of Siberian region, it reaches to about 60 degrees Celsius. The same case is observed with Canadian big land mass, but with lesser intensity. But in southern hemisphere, it is not that much great. Now coming to the vertical distribution of temperature. You might have already studied about the composition and structure of atmosphere in module 3 and insulation in module 5. Here our concern is to study vertical temperature distribution, but only within the troposphere. We would not discuss the distribution of temperature beyond this limit. In general, temperature declines upward from the surface of the earth in troposphere till the upper limit, that is tropopause. This decreasing temperature is termed as lapse rate. Generally, it is called normal lapse rate, in which air keeps on laying at its place and someone or thermometer moves upward. In this way, temperature is measured. This drop is 6.5 degrees Celsius per kilometer of ascent. It is also termed as vertical temperature gradient. The normal lapse rate is not always the same but it differs depending upon height, season, latitude, or other numerous local factors. Now, let us talk about the inversion of temperature. In certain conditions, temperature is not always declining with increasing altitude, but it rises. This situation is known as inversion of temperature. The term inversion means opposite to the normal. Since the normal is fall in temperature with altitude, under inversion, it rises with the increasing height. It happens when the air near surface is cooler than upper air. Now, coming to the ideal conditions for temperature inversion. Temperature inversion takes place only under certain conditions. Important among them are, there has to be long and cool night so that Earth radiates received solar energy. There has to be clear sky so that terrestrial radiation escapes. There has to be calm and stable air so that vertical motion in the air is absent. Now, coming to the types of temperature inversion. Primarily, there are several types of inversion of temperature. Important among them are ground inversion, valley inversion, subsidence inversion, and frontal inversion. Coming to ground inversion. Ground inversion occurs when the surface is cooled rapidly by Earth radiation under clear sky. In this way, temperature above the ground is still warmer than the air near the ground. When temperature near the surface reaches to dew level, the possibility of fog formation increases. Ground inversion is very common in the higher latitude areas or during winter in the plain, even in tropical regions. Coming to valley inversion. Valley inversion takes place on the rolling topography, particularly in hilly areas. In such situation, mountain slope becomes cool in night and the air with its contact gets cooler. Cooler air creeps downward along the slope and occupies the valley. The warm air of the valley pushed up and thus the inversion of temperature is evident. Coming to subsidence inversion. Subsidence inversion takes place mostly in subtropical high pressure belts or leeward side of the mountain where air subsides. In either of the cases, subsiding air gets warmed in this process while the lower level pre-existing air is cooler. The warming is achieved about 10 degrees Celsius per kilometer of ascending air. Therefore, lower level air seems to be cooler than the plunging air above. In this situation, the subsidence inversion of temperature is caused. Now, coming to the frontal inversion. As the name suggests, that the type of inversion of temperature takes place under the frontal formation of two different air masses. When cold and heavier air mass undercuts warm sector occupied by warm air mass, the warm air is lifted up, the ground is occupied with cold air, and thus inversion is observed. Now, let us conclude this module. The main source of energy on the Earth is sun. It is known as insulation which comes in the form of electromagnetic radiation. Horizontally, it is varying widely since the temperature is governed by insulation. Temperature on the earth has wide variations. The variations in the temperature are controlled by several factors. Latitude plays an important role because the angle of incidence of the sun rays and its effectiveness is determined. Altitude also affects distribution of temperature because higher elevation has lower temperature and vice versa. Both height and temperature are inversely related. Length of the day is determined by other factors as well, but the thumb rule is that longer the day, greater is the received energy from the incoming solar radiations, and hence more temperature is recorded. However, the incidence of sun rays plays the most effective role. That is why, in spite of long duration of days in the polar region, temperature is very low. Continentality has a very great regulating force to determine temperature. The interior of the continents has extreme temperature records. In summer, they are very hot, but in winter, they are extremely cold. The prevailing winds redistribute temperature over the globe. The same is done by ocean currents. Both of them are modifying temperature in the area of their influence. The slope and aspects also determine the receiving of the energy from the sun. The characteristics of land and its surface along with vegetation have good control over the distribution of temperature. Overall, horizontal distribution of temperature keeps on declining from equator during July, when it is summer for northern hemisphere and winter for southern hemisphere. Sun is directly shining over Tropic of Cancer and nearby areas. High temperature is recorded there, but in southern hemisphere temperature is low. Therefore, the highest temperature is over Tropic of Cancer, and from here the temperature keeps on reducing till poles. The temperature gradient is very strong in the polar areas as isotherms are very close. During July, it is the severest in southern pole areas. During January, summer conditions prevail in southern hemisphere, but for northern hemisphere, it is winter. The case of July is comparatively reversed in January. The annual range of temperature is very low in equatorial region, as sun is almost vertical near to vertical throughout the year. The areas in high latitudes experiences very high annual range of temperature. In equatorial region, it is just 3 degrees Celsius or less, while in polar continental regions of Asian Siberia, annual range of temperature is over 60 degrees Celsius. It is caused by extreme low temperature in winter, but in summer temperature is moderate, which makes the difference between the two a big one. Vertically, temperature is on declining trend in general. The drop in temperature is 6.5 degrees Celsius per kilometer of ascent from Earth's surface. It is called normal lapse rate or environmental lapse rate. Under certain conditions, the temperature increases with height and it is called the inversion of temperature. there could be different kinds of inversion. Ground inversion takes place when the ground is cooled quickly and the warmer air is above. In hilly areas, slope becomes cool and the cool air in its contact creeps downward in the valley under the influence of gravity. The pre-existing warm air of the valley is pushed up in polar subtropical region of subsiding air to leeward side of the mountain gets warmer up by 10 degrees Celsius per kilometer of downward movement. Due to adiabatic warming, the air already existing is cooler than the descending air. When cold air mass undercut warm sector air of warm air mass, warm air lifted and the cold air occupies the ground. This type is known as frontal inversion of temperature. Thank you. Thank you very much.